Hello students, welcome back to English class of online learning with Skill Build. This is the second class of prepositions, and in this class today we are going to learn about two prepositions. And the first one is without, and its meaning is ke bina, or we can say lack of something. Let's take some examples. Tea without sugar, chini ke bina chai. He can't see without spectacles. वह बिना चश्मे के नहीं देख सकता. Sita won't go without Ram. Ram के बिना सीता नहीं जाएगी. Our next preposition is at, and its meaning is per. Some of you must be thinking that at का meaning तो में होता है. So when to use at, where to use at, and how to use. In today's class, we are going to learn all these things with the different uses of at, with point of time, with festival, with small places, and with night or noon. Let's learn the first use of at, that is for telling exact time. जो जर्नली हमें स्कूल में बताया जाता है कि at का use exact time बताने के लिए किया जाता है. Let's learn with the example. He will meet him at 2 o'clock. वह उससे 2 बजे मिलेगा. She was born at 4 o'clock. वह 4 बजे पैदा हुई थी. I have a meeting at 3 o'clock. मेरी 3 बजे एक मीटिंग है. इन सभी सेंटेंसेस में एक्सैक्ट टाइम गिवन था, इसीलिए हमने एट यूज़ किया. लेट्स लर्न द नेक्स्ट यूज ऑफ एट, दैट इज एट फॉर टेलिंग अबाउट फेस्टिवल और इवेंट. आई मेट हिम एट दिवाली. मैं उसे दिवाली पर मिला था. I came home at your birthday. मैं आपके जन्मदिन पर घर आया था. I had a great time at Holi. मैंने होली पर बहुत अच्छा समय बिताया. इन सभी सेंटेंसेस में किसी इवेंट या किसी फेस्टिवल की बात की गई है, और उसको बताने के लिए हमने प्रपोजिशन यूज़ की है एट. तो हम एट को किसी फेस्टिवल या इवेंट के बारे में बताने के लिए भी यूज़ कर सकते हैं. लेट्स लर्न द नेक्स्ट यूज ऑफ एट. At for defining small places. At relation with in. As I told you in the starting of the video, कि आप में से बहुत सारे लोग ये सोच रहे होंगे at का meaning तो में होता है. तो at का meaning कब में होता है और at और in का क्या relation है, वो अभी हम ये वाले step में सीखने जा रहे हैं. At को हम छोटे places को define करने के लिए भी use करते हैं. Better to learn with the example. So let's take example. The first example is I live in Sonipat. मैं सोनीपत में रहता हूँ. I live at Sonipat in Haryana. मैं हरियाणा के सोनीपत जिले में रहता हूँ. I live at Haryana in India. मैं भारत के हरियाणा में रहता हूँ. Now you must be thinking I have used preposition in with Sonipat in first sentence, and in second sentence I have used at. Why is this happening? So let's learn the difference of in and at here. In first example, I have used in with Sonipat. There I am considering Sonipat as a district, जिसको मैं एक शहर से बड़ा मानती हूँ. ठीक है. In second sentence, Sonipat is smaller than Haryana, because Haryana is a state and Sonipat is a district of that. So if I'm talking about these two together, then I will use at with Sonipat. And in the next example, I have used at for Haryana and in for India, as Haryana is smaller than India. India is a country and Haryana is a state under that country. So this is the difference between at and in. So at is used for the small place. I think it is clear to you. Let's check some more examples.
So the first one is I stayed at in hotel. मैं एक होटल में रुका. I have used at and in both here, and you also can use the same. At, because we are talking about hotel, which is a small place in comparison to our home or a city. And we can use in because the action of being staying there is already being done. It's not in process at this time. So we can use in. I was at home yesterday. Main kal ghar par tha. She works at in a mall. वह एक मॉल में काम करती है. As I told you earlier, we can use any of these two, at or in.
Let's learn the next use of at, that is with night and noon. Let's learn with the example. He came home at night. वह रात में घर आया. I will meet you at noon. मैं आपसे दोपहर में मिलूंगा. He will join us at noon. वह दोपहर में हमें मिलेगा. So these are the different uses of at we have learnt in this video. I will meet you soon with the next video of prepositions. And thanks for watching this video. Please like, share and subscribe my channel. And keep learning. Stay blessed. Happy learning. Bye-bye.